Do you know what love bombing is? You may have an idea of the term, but in today's video, I want to give you the 6 warning signs that you're being love bombed. I'll talk about what's typically underneath the love bombing behavior and who's more likely to love bomb you. Definition of love bombing from Urban Dictionary. When someone comes back all of a sudden to shower you with over-the-top displays of affection, flirtation, etc. They have been hot and cold with you over and over, in your life 1 minute and then ghosting you the next without warning. We're hearing more and more about this term love bombing. And I want you to be able to differentiate what is normal, like I like you excitement at the beginning of a relationship, versus what is more sinister love bombing. Because when you first meet someone, being swept off your feet can feel like fun. It's exciting. Your brain is flooded with serotonin, the feel-good drug. You're euphoric on cloud nine. And if someone showers you with love and affection and admiration, isn't this a good thing? At least in the movies, this is what love looks like. So what's the problem? Let me give you an example from my own life of a time that I was love bombed, and I want to hear what you think. Okay, so I meet this guy, I met him online, and we went out for coffee on a Saturday afternoon. We met for brunch, had a really nice time. I thought he was lovely. I thought, well, sure, I'll definitely see him again. But he was going on a trip the next day and he was going to be out of town for a week. And he was really eager to meet with me again. And I said, oh, don't worry about it. We'll get together when you get back. Sure enough, the next day I go to work. And mind you, he doesn't really know me. And there are 2 dozen roses from him. I think, huh, okay, well, this is nice. He's clearly interested, but then the next day and the day after and the day after, every day at my office door, 2 dozen roses. I thought, wow, that's a bit over the top. And then of course I felt like I needed to call him to thank him and we would end up spending lots of time on the phone. But I tell you this as a warning because those roses came with thorns. And I want you to look not just at the behavior, but the meaning and the symbolism of the behavior to understand truly what love bombing is. Because if you recognize these, it's not necessarily that your partner is toxic, but their attempts to woo you is that it's really not about you, the gift receiver, it's about them, the person who's love bombing you. But let's go over what are the signs that you're being love bombed. 1, typical love bombing is that they overwhelm you with gifts. I've heard trips, gift cards, and it's a pace that feels intense. They don't even know you. Like the roses, he didn't even know if I liked roses or not. But the motivation of the gift is what we're talking about. Is it genuine? Or is there a subtle manipulation? And the attention that they give you or the gift doesn't feel very personal. Again, how do you know I even like roses by the time you're giving it to me? It says more about the giver than the receiver. What about 2, a second warning sign? That they're giving you too much attention, too many phone calls, texts. There's an intensity that also feels like it's driven by them. Oh, just one more thing. I need to let you know. How about this? What about that? And it feels like they can't contain themselves. They don't have a filter. Warning sign 3, you're being love bombed. They want a commitment. That's part of the subtle manipulation under the gift, is that they want it and they want it now. They might be jealous coming in quickly, talking about other people in your life. Oh, you don't have time for me, but you have time for everybody else. And in this situation, like what happened for me, in this needing a commitment quickly. Before you knew it, then I found myself in a relationship with this person. He was a single dad, and before you know it, somehow I'm like over at his house taking care of his children while he's taking a trip. I suddenly felt like I was the nanny, only I wasn't paid, and it happened like that. Even I, as a psychologist, missed the sign. Step number four, or sign number four, is how all of this makes you feel. Because at the time, remember, excitement and fear all get very complicated, but you feel a little bit rocked, uneasy, like, wow, things are moving so fast. But you don't see what's happening with all of the confusion. Why does it move so quickly? Not because you want it to move that way, but somehow they want it to move this quickly. So I'm asking you to check in with yourself. How do these behaviors make you feel? If you're feeling unsettled, uneasy, maybe that you need to maintain a certain level of perfectionism, like I also felt, then you might need to say, what is happening here? Okay, another warning sign. They speak quickly of a future without even knowing you. They're talking about wanting to get married, about the future. What are we going to name our children? They're moving very quickly. And you're thinking to yourself, what's the rush? Where is this coming from? Warning sign number six. They're overly needy and they're attention seeking. They want you to love them quickly, to think that they're the best, to profess your love to them, and it all feels very intense. And while you might think that love bombing happens at the beginning of a relationship primarily, it can happen at any point in a relationship too. But typically what's underneath this behavior is it's driven by an inflection point where there's some kind of stress. So for instance, you're going along and now they worry that you are pulling back and they're gonna lose you. And all of a sudden now they're coming forward with more gifts again. They're coming forward with, let's take this long exaggerated trip. And remember, it doesn't feel so much about you, let's get away together. It's about them and what they want, or they wanna look like they're a really good person. It could also be a cover up for other negative behaviors. Imagine that the person is cheating on you, but to cover it up, they're gonna give you a smokescreen like a bomb and give you lots of loving behaviors so you wouldn't even think. Okay, so if you have to ask the question, have I been love bombed? The question I put back to you is, would someone in a normal relationship or a secure functioning person need to try so hard? Right? That's the question. Because if your answer is no, then certainly we have to look at what's going on underneath. Why is the person love bombing you? Where is this behavior coming from? In my clinical experience, what I've noticed is beneath the insecure behaviors is oftentimes a very insecure person who's doing the love bombing. And as I see it, there's two types that are more likely to love bomb you. There's the avoidant person, who, if you've taken my love style quiz, you know that might be more the independent person, independent Ian or Isabel. They have a complicated relationship. They seek intimacy, but they also need a fair amount of distance and space, and they can get flooded easily. Then there's also the anxious attached person who could also love bomb you more from a place of their own insecurities and that they don't want to be abandoned or rejected. And so if you quickly move into relationship with them, they don't have to actually process this anxiety because now you're moving this relationship at a very fast pace, and they don't have to wonder what would it be like if you did reject them. But remember, if the behaviors are more manipulative and the person is defensive, that's what we're talking about. It's a pattern, or as the Urban Dictionary said, it's more of a pattern of hot and cold behaviors. It's not just, is this love bombing, yes or no? It's the pattern of what's happening here. So the question I ask for you, what can you do if you fear that someone is love bombing you? That's going to depend on who the person is. Consider the source. If it comes from a more anxious person and it's more benign and not so manipulative, then all you have to do is reassure this person that you are there for them and that you like them, and the behavior will naturally calm down. You can say things like, I like you a lot, and you really don't need to buy me all these gifts, because it just feels like a little bit too much in the timing. You do know that you are enough on your own, but maybe if you wanted to give me a gift like that after we knew each other a little bit better or for my birthday, then that might be different. Typically, this person, when you reassure them that you like them, they are, again, going to calm down, and that should help. But now, what if you're dealing with more the avoidant person or someone who is a narcissist? And that way, you are going to know by their response to your feedback. So let's say you tell the narcissist, you know, all of this gift giving and everything, it just actually feels too intense for me. I don't feel like we're there yet. And you try to set a boundary about talking about what makes you comfortable. This will not go well with a narcissist. So maybe they'll say something like, oh, what, my gifts aren't good enough for you? You know, who do you think you are? Maybe some other woman would appreciate me more. Can you hear the gaslighting comments there? Because, excuse me, they're trying to blame you. They don't take ownership for their behavior. They wouldn't say something like, wow, I can see that that was a little bit intense. Sorry, I didn't mean to overwhelm you. I was just excited. No, they're not going to say that. They're going to be defensive, and they see themselves as better than you. And therefore, what's wrong with you that you are rejecting their gift? There must be a problem with you. So the key differentiator in who is the person who's doing the love bombing is the way they handle critical feedback. As I said, the anxious person would be more likely to say, wow, yeah, that was a little bit intense. Sorry, I really like you. The narcissist is going to gaslight you, make it about you, and not take any responsibility for their behavior. Does that make sense? Regardless, sometimes it might feel nice to be showered with gifts. Not all gifts are love bombing either. If the gift is genuine, someone, for instance, knows that you like chocolate and they bring you chocolate, that's not a love bomb. That's a genuine, sweet gift. And it's not manipulative either, because this gift is meant to please you, not to please them. Do you hear the difference in that too? So if the gift is more about the giver and they're trying to cover up their insecurities and push you into a relationship with them sooner than you're comfortable or ready, then you might be love bombed. And if you notice a lot of inconsistencies coming on hot or strong, and or they back off and then all of a sudden they feel guilty and come forward a lot, again, pay very close attention to that. Now, I want to go deep into also narcissism, but I want to actually talk about that in another entire video, because one of my more popular posts on Instagram was, how do you know if he's just a narcissist or he's an asshole? So catch me over there, but I want to make sure that you subscribe to my channel, leave me comments, let me know what you're thinking, and I want to help you get back to love.